Hi friends, let us see another problem of Butterworth filter design and let us understand if such type of problem is given, how to solve it. In this section, the problem that we have considered is using a bilinear transformation, design a Butterworth filter which satisfies the following conditions. Now the conditions which are given is of digital filter. The conditions that we have to meet is h of e raised to j omega should be in between 0.1 and 1, and h of e raised to j omega should be less than equal to 0.2 in the frequency range of 0.6 pi to pi. So if I draw this characteristics, what I will get is I will plot this is my, let's say, omega, and this is mod of h of e raised to j omega. Then I will demark four lines. One line will be of the frequency corresponding to 0.6 pi, and let's say first is 0.2 pi. Next frequency I will demark is 0.6 pi. Let's bring it a bit closer. So this is 0.6 pi, and finally what I have is a pi. Okay, this is about frequency information given to us. Now let us demark the lines for the amplitude given to us. So one amplitude is given as 0.2 pi. So this is 0.2, not pi, so just 0.2, this value. Then we have a 0.8 factor. So let us mark a line for 0.8, and finally we will mark 1. This is 1. Okay, so we have marked all the lines. Now let us draw how the curve will look like. Now h of e raised to j omega is in between 0.8 and 1, in between the frequencies from, let's say, 0 to 0.2 pi. That means the frequency response will be like this, and then it goes below 0.2 after 0.6, or at 0.6 it is equal to 0.2, and after that it goes below 0.2 and till pi it remains 0.2 or below that. Okay, so this is the curve, or these are the characteristics that we are designing for. So let us denote or mark the values, or what are the characteristics given. So this is we called as the passband edge, which is omega p. This is the stopband edge, which is omega s. This is a stopband attenuation, which we called as as. This is a passband attenuation, which we called as ap. So the passband attenuation given as 0.8, stopband attenuation is given as 0.2, passband edge frequency is 0.2 pi, and stopband edge frequency is 0.6 pi, and the filter is normalized to 1. So the amplitude, maximum amplitude, will be 1. Now they have not mentioned anything about cutoff frequency, neither mentioned about the order. Everything has to be designed by a designer. Only this characteristics has been given to us to visualize that too. They were given these things, we have visualized it like this. So from the visualization, I can draw several conclusions. First conclusion is it is a low pass filter, digital low pass filter. Second conclusion that we can draw, it's a Butterworth filter. Okay, then we can also write the given criteria, that is AP requirement is 0.8, AS requirement is 0.2, omega p requirement is 0.2 pi and omega s requirement is 0.6 pi. Right. So, these are the four values given to us. Now, let us start our designing. And very important, the characteristics are not given in analog domain but given in digital domain. And we do not have a direct design methodology of designing a Butterworth filter, digital Butterworth filter. We need to take the help of analog filter. So, the first step that I will be doing is, so let us say step 1. Step 1 is to obtain, okay, analog domain values. So, this first we have to do, we have to find the analog domain values. For magnitude response, I am not concerned about much in magnitude response, because magnitude remains the same whether we are in analog or whether we are in digital. So, AP in analog will also remain the same as 0.8 and AS will also remain the same as 0.2. They will not change because analog and digital both the attenuation constants will remain the same. Only what will change is the frequency. Now, we have to go from digital frequency to analog frequency. Now, from digital to analog frequency conversion, I need to carefully look at the problem again. How do I convert? So, for the conversion, they have mentioned one problem that we have to use a bilinear transformation method only. So, with the bilinear transformation method, now I can design or I can find omega p, which is equal to 2 by t tan of omega p by 2, and omega s will be equal to 2 by t into tan of omega s by 2. We know what is omega p is and we know what is omega s is, so we will get the capital omega and capital omega p by assuming ts to be or t to be 1 second. So, I will have 2 tan of omega p as 0.2 pi by 2 and omega s as 2 tan of omega s is 0.6 pi by 2. What we have assumed here, assume t to be equal to 1, that is the important catch over here. Okay, because t is not mentioned in the problem. So, we will assume t to be 1 second. Now, omega p you will get as 0.65 radians per second and omega s you will obtain as 2.75 radians per second. So, these are the two values that I have obtained, omega p, omega s, ap, as, all four values are with me for the analog domain. Now, let us start designing. Now, the first step is to get the order of the filter. So, to get the order of the filter, or let us say step 2, to obtain order of filter. Now, to obtain the order of filter, the formula is n greater than equal to 1 by 2 log to the base 10, okay, into, okay, 1 upon a s square minus 1 divided by 1 upon a p square minus 1 the whole divided by log to the base 10 into omega s by omega p. So, the n order of the filter we can get by putting the value of the constants. So, let us put the values. N will be greater than equal to 1 by 2 log to the base 10. This will be 1 upon our AS is 0.2 square minus 1 divided by 1 upon AP is 0.8 square minus 1 the whole divided by log to the base 10 omega s is a 2.75 and omega p was 0.65. After calculating, okay, your n will be somewhere around this factor will come give you value as 1.3. Now you cannot design a filter with a fractional order, like you cannot have a filter with 1.3. That's why when writing formula, I have not written it as n equal to, I have written n greater than or equal to. If this factor comes in integer, that time you use the equal to sign. If it does not gives you an integer back, then use greater than equal to. And now I will design for n approximately equal to 2 and not 1.3. So instead of 1.3, if I design a filter at an order 2, of course my slope or roll off rate will be better. So this will actually improvise the characteristics of the filter. So how much greater should I consider? Should I consider 4? Should I consider 8? So this equal to sign does not comment on that. Okay, that greater than sign does not comment on that, that you can consider it as 4 also, you can consider as 3 also, you can consider any number greater than 1.3. But when you increase the order of the filter, the elements that you put in the filter also increases. One filter design, this will not create a problem. But if you are designing a filter in a bulk, then each element will cost you some ransom of amount, and then a bulk production will actually affect your cost of the filter. So it is always good to keep the value close to 2 or just next higher integer. Now with the order, we will go to cutoff frequency. So step 3 is to obtain cutoff frequency. So let us obtain the cutoff frequency. The cutoff frequency omega c is equal to omega p upon 1 upon AP square minus 1 raised to 1 by 2n. Now, the reason behind finding order first was because the order will be required in the cutoff frequency. So now the cutoff frequency will be omega c, which is equal to omega p is 0.65 divided by 1 upon 0.8 the whole square minus 1 the whole raised to 1 by, now the order is 2, so 2 into 2 becomes 4. Therefore, omega c after calculation will be 0.75 radians per second. So omega c will surely be in the given characteristics. If I see the characteristics again, then omega c will surely be in between omega p and omega s. So it will be somewhere in between this factor only. That will be the cutoff frequency. Wherever my roll off rate will reach the 50% value of the maxima, that time I will get the omega c, which will be in between omega p and omega s. So that is my omega c. Once you have obtained omega c, now we will directly go for transfer function. The transfer function h of s, so let us say step 4, analog transfer function. So the analog transfer function h of s is given as omega c raised to n divided by continued product of s is equal to 1 to n by 2 S square plus BS omega C S plus omega C the whole square. Okay. So, if I find what is n by 2, so now with this consideration, let us start our calculation of BS. Now, in this case, BS will take only one value because n by 2 will be equal to 1. So, I will write BS, which is equal to now only B1, which is equal to 2 times of sine 2k minus 1 by 2n into pi. So, that will give me 2 sine 2k minus 1 will be 2 into k is 1. So, I will put 1 minus 1. So, this will be 2 minus 1, which is 1 into pi will be pi divided by 4. Okay. Therefore, B1 is 2 sine pi by 4. Now, after substituting B1 over here, my h of s will look like h of s is equal to, let us now put all the values. So, when I put omega c n, my omega c was 0.75. So, it will be 0.75 square divided by s square plus. Now, if I put 2 sine pi by 4, calculate its value multiplied by 0.57 will give me the value as 1.06s plus I will again get 0.75 square. Okay. So, let us calculate it. So, 0.57 will give 75 square will give me answer as 0.56 divided by s square plus 1.06s plus 0.56. So, this is the transfer function that I have obtained for analog filter, but I wanted to design a digital filter. So, for digital filter, I will go for step 5. Digital, or we can say discrete filter transfer function. Okay, discrete, you can say discrete time also, no problem. Discrete time filter transfer function. Okay, so we wanted to find h of z, which is equal to h of s at s equals to 2 by t. 1 minus z inverse upon 1 plus z inverse. Why this is so? Because in problem they have asked us to use bilinear transformation method. So, in bilinear transformation method, h of z is equal to h of s with this relationship. So, now I will replace all my h of s's. So, I will get numerator was 0.56, will remain as it is, divided by s square will be 2 by t, we are considering to be 1. So, it will be 2 into 1 minus z inverse upon 1 plus z inverse plus 1.06 into 2, 1 minus z inverse upon 1 plus z inverse plus 0.56. So, this is what the value will be. Now, if you want to solve further, this will be the whole square because it is s square. So, if you want to solve it further, you can solve it further by taking 1 plus z inverse square, multiplying as a whole, taking it to the numerator, and the whole solution will be h of z as 0.56 into z plus 1 the whole square divided by 6.68 z square minus 6.88 z plus 2.44. So, this will be the final transfer function when you will solve this transfer function, and that will actually give you the final result. Thank you.